This is a cardiac ultrasound, and I want to make this for you to suggest to increase the depth. We'll go over the other clefts, but there is a clear pericardial effusion, but you don't see the descending aorta. You need to increase your depth to truly see if the effusion goes around the heart. This is a apical four, and again, you can clearly see the effusion, but you really want to increase your depth to not just look at the left atrium, right atrium, but again to see how extensive the effusion is. Just by looking at the apex here, I don't think you have all the information that you can gather. It's also difficult to tell with this depth if there's tamponade. I don't think so, but by increasing the depth, that would have helped make that assessment. Last thing, when you find a pericardial effusion, your next step really should be to look at the IVC. If you have a collapsing IVC, there's no chance there could be any tamponade physiology. If the IVC is plump, doesn't tell you that much, but that would be consistent with tamponade, though you can have many pericardial effusions with no tamponade with a plump IVC. It's one of these questions where if it's a IVC that's collapsing, it's very helpful because then there's no tamponade. If it's plump, doesn't really give you much of an answer. Hope this video helps. Again, the main issue is the depth. I would have increased it.